key, I'll go out in our yard right now and I'll find short.
I'm talking about
maybe drop the set.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't let him drop.
No?
I did on Monday. If we have a house where
we used to have these old paintings to go on again.
They bundle all of that together. I don't know if they're
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, just crazy. They bundle it all together.
That's
what they can't take much of them out of there.
Yeah,
they're
you must have been in the building.
You walked out west, you walked in that way. I'll tell you the thing, Brooke, and you were here. Hey, I got here around, you got to put it in.
I did.
I heard you said it, they walked away. You walked away. You hit the hard
That's a guy, man. He's out of like your range.
Yeah.
got one right over here.
You see the roof there with the yellow piping there?
So what is this harness? Does it have to wrap around my entire?
Is it really? guess the good way for these guys to hold it.
This is the shot he wants, right?
Yeah.
John Strachan's great. He's real mellow. He's like real mellow. Mm-hmm. They're both good.
Peter's good.
Mm-hmm.
You got more, married more?
Trying to. But it's not easy. It's not easy to keep it in there with other people. It's just really hard to find people that she thinks are qualified.
Are we sending
so good with her friend going to go and get along with her. But everything that she's got to learn, she can't wait.
Now, the next one, they're going to bring up that big piece.
Oh, cool.
So that'd be a cool shot.
Just got to remember to get my black jacket on.
Yeah.
So
they close down Wall Street.
Don't let them tell you, they want somebody they don't even know.
Right.
I mean, I always get the paper.
Okay.
Same store.
But I never saw her.
Because she had like a little plaid poncho on. What do they work?
Yeah.
Are they?
Yeah,
like
from that group picture.
Yeah, they're many pictures. This photographer at the San Francisco convention, like, had eyes only for Sydney. It's like everywhere was that.
Like,
it was really, it was really weird. This guy clearly had a thing for you.
Well, he probably didn't have much of an audience to shoot.
So they just got this one final piece. I still want to see it.
No, the last piece we have already.
I think they got one more.
Yeah, Fox News.
Yep, I might be wrong. Is there one more piece that's going up?
Yeah, it's one more.
Good to have you.
Thank you. Good to
be
up here. No, not at all. Is he going to buy one of those TV?
No, he's with Teal TV.
Oh, short. Gray hair. How's he like Teal TV?
Ah, he does.
Wait, it's him.
What do you have? 212?
212.
What's for the, do we take the window out?
And we got time to wait. Sit here.
What more Bob Jordan was in?
Right.
Four. Oh, yeah. I said that. There's another brunette lady.
I think that was
Channel 9 or something. I think she was.
Where do, where is our?
She looks familiar.
You got pretty good money. You went in the movie?
Hell no. Didn't let me in that thing. Not even an extra.
So what you were just engineer on site?
Yeah, because they transformed our shop into the hostage thing.
So you had to be there, though, right?
Yeah, I had to be. That's why.
You got paid, though, huh?
Yeah, a lot of overtime.
So what was the other building they wanted to shoot this from? So that's for this one in the quake. Was there another one?
Yeah, one. Two south.
They blew it?
Because the sun set on it. They on the outside shots right here on the street.
Yeah, they started too late.
Yeah, they went way over budget. That movie in Chicago.
Yeah, I think it was.
It was a $40 million.
Yeah, I think it was $49 million, but
they blew $1 million the first day.
I could have done it for 20. But see how they
jump out of a building.
Except Lud might have been working out 12, 14 hours.
Man, he was here all night. All night.
But see, well, you know what
Kyle was saying? It's
like Kylie was saying, man. The time factor, you know, when it starts getting toward that equinox, hours are going dead. Boom, and it's zooming, man. Minutes are zooming.
So that money is going out the window.
And then you got to have. I mean, it's a great time of the year to shoot because, I mean, the light is just excellent. Yeah, excellent light. But look how much more money you're going to spend. Plus, on top of this, hey, you know, it's a union town, man.
Yeah.
The unions, man, you got those guys. 12 hours. They can't go over 14 hours because then you got to have 12 hours off. But see, that's what it was. They had to give them at least 12 hours off to come back.
They start late the next day.
That's why I was born. You know, something like that. It was better for him.
Soundstage over here on the
ground. 2X is a pretty nice shot.
That's it.
Oh, you talking
about?
Yeah. Yeah, Italian guy. Yeah, I know you're talking about.
They had to go back to LA
and do all the things. Well, yeah,
sure.
It's much cheaper. You gotta probably get a better deal.
With a
turnaround,
of course.
Oh, really?
But you know what? If they wanted to do it, he should have done it in the summer. It should have done it around.
Too many crews.
Summer is when they go in hiatus. See, they should have done it then where the days are longer, like around mid June, where the days are longer. Although light is not like it used to be. But they could have done it then. Could have saved some money.
So the piss they have down there, that's the next one. Right?
The days are longer. Then now you can do the 12 hours.
They wanted it down there, or the one the pieces that they have.
The one down here, and then they got to put up the, maybe they have to put up the braces.
I heard the same guy who did.
The things laying on the ground.
What's the one with
But so far they've had 4 trips.
Yeah.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
So there will be a less one.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I'm sure there's
like that's the next that is gonna be still the one on the floor.
AD guy.
The small pieces they already have it up there.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't know. How they're gonna do this.
Now that ends in
you were talking about that. I used to stop on the road. It's just like it was just dusting.
That's bizarre.
What if we go down there? Oh, crap. Is your car locked? Dunkin' Donuts.
Oh, yeah, that's Dunkin' Donuts.
There's an urgent issue.
I think I get with the program.
I guess that qualifies as a soldier, actually.
Oh man, I'm glad I see you, man. I got this tape, man, to give to.
You turned it for a drive in 26 hours.
No, me too. Charles. 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 Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, give it to Dwayne, man.
Pay him.
Didn't pay him nothing, man. Just told him what to do. Then I got a job. I got to go up this line, man. It's nice to look down. I like it a lot. I like it a lot.
Well, that's free. I mean,
she actually has some office restaurant.
I don't know.
I mean, it's all new information.
Ryan, I'm seeing your reflection.
So what do you want me to do?
That's good right there.
Yeah.
pulling out. where am I supposed to look?
You're supposed to look, you should look at the camera.
Okay.
So I'm going to ask you the questions, but you talk right into the camera.
Okay.
So tell me when, rolling in space. Okay. I'm going to ask you the questions that they ask, and I'm going to ask you a few more. Okay, so something you're going to do. Explain what 38 gigahertz wireless service is.
Okay. 38 gigahertz wireless services, broadband services that are actually wireless from the customer building to our network. And our network is fiber-backed, Sonnet protected. But the 38 gigahertz, the premise of it is that it's broad bandwidth, virtually unlimited bandwidth. And we can provide a spectrum of services to customers through it, regular telephone service all the way up to high-speed data, internet access. And enhanced services.
It's too hard to look at things, so look at me. Okay, so just focus on me.
Okay.
why is this a preferred technology?
Well, one of the reasons it's preferred is because it is broad bandwidth. The telecom market is changing at a rapid rate. The bandwidth needs in the marketplace are continuing to grow, and 38 gigahertz being as broad bandwidth as it is can keep up with it. Also, the technology is wireless, which enables us to get into buildings at a lower cost, and thus, you know, providing high bandwidth services as well as telephone services at a lower cost to customers.
What kind of tenants need the services provided by this?
Really, every tenant will need these types of services. Again, we sell everything from regular phone service, we call ourselves the new phone company, to high broad bandwidth services. Our target market coming into the marketplace is going to be small and medium-sized customers with one of our groups, and then also major accounts, which are larger accounts that we're going to be focusing in on. So really, anyone can utilize Winstar services.
Tell us exactly what's in this building. I mean, why did you pick this building? What significance does it have to the whole process of building a network?
Well, the significance of this building, we chose it for two reasons, really. One, its location, and its visibility to other buildings. It's a hub, and thereby it's connected with fiber. It's part of our network. It needs to be able to see a lot of buildings because that's where we use the 38 gigahertz technology to bring those buildings into our network. So that's the first criteria. The second criteria is that he has a lot of other services in the building, which enables us to provide not only our own services to customers, but we have a pipeline for any service in the city through, he has a lot of them in his building. We can just interconnect with them and provide those services to customers as well.
Okay, let's see. So basically, do you require, how many dishes do you have up there? You're gonna be on the top of this building.
I think we're starting out with 50 on this building. We have the capability of growing to about 70.
And when you get these all up there, are you going to be covering Chicago?
Well, we're going to cover, with this one hub site, we can cover about 30% of the loop. And we can bring 30% of the loop into this hub site here.
Well, that's great. So do you already have customers here in Chicago?
Yes, we do. Actually, we've done very well. We entered this market back in January, and we had virtually nothing, no network, anything. Today, we have quite a few customers. We have, you know, small customers, and we also have some very large customers.
So tell me, you have a switch up there in that building. Will, is that correct?
Actually, our switch is at 101 North Wacker. Basically, in this building, we're doing routing.
So then talk to me about the concept of in addition to putting up these wireless connections, you also are doing switching. Can you talk about that in very briefly?
Switch services?
Yes.
Yeah, basically switch services are, you know, are the same as telephone services and the features that come along with telephone services. We have a 5ESS switch at 101 North Wacker, and that is also part of our network, which means that we can provide those services to any building that is on net. And in basically switch services are telephone services with the features that come along with that, Centrix type features, you know, call forward, call waiting, the typical features that come with telephone service.
So what do you expect your customers to look more for you? For just pipes, bandwidth, or do you expect them to look for the switch services? Where will they be?
Actually, I think both, and it depends on the size of customer. we, you know, most of our marketing is going to be to the small and medium-sized customers initially, and they'll be most interested in the switch services. As we enter into the larger accounts, which actually we entered into those accounts this month, they'll be wanting the you know, a range of services. They'll want the switch services. And they'll also want broadband, high-speed data services, as well as backup to wireline services.
Great. Denise, I'm going to stop.
Okay, background's going to blow out.
Is there a star on the trailer door?
Right.
Yeah. Rolling.
Okay, go ahead, Cynthia.
Tell us about your building, the address, how old it is, Lurie Company,
how many buildings you have. All right, my name is Lawrence Cohen. I'm Vice President of the Lurie Company. Lurie Company is a California corporation based in San Francisco. We own 3 buildings in downtown Chicago and 14 buildings in downtown San Francisco. The building we're here talking about today is the LaSalle-Wacker building. Its address is 221 North LaSalle Street. It's a 42-story structure that was, it's an Art Deco building designed by Hollerbird and Root, opened in 1930. The marketplace in Chicago right now is quite strong. At the time we entered into negotiations with Winstar for the antenna structure that you see behind me, the market was not as strong. From 1990 or 91 and through about 1995 and early 96, it was a depressed marketplace. The supply was a lot greater than the demand. So it caused us to have a vision as to what we thought were necessities for businesses going forward in the future. The building currently has a number of amenities. It has a restaurant, a garage, a bank, and a number of other, what we would call amenities, a health club, what have you. We were looking more for our tenants' needs and kind of partnering with them going into the future. And we think that a necessity such as telecommunications means more to a tenant these days than maybe a cold sandwich for lunch. So with that in mind, we went into negotiations with Winstar to put an equipment switch in the building and to put an antenna on top of the building. And it's basically changed the skyscape of the city. It's a joint venture between both parties. The antenna portion of the structure is 15 feet, which is Winstar and their antenna capacity, and 24 feet on top of that is the light pipe that you will see, which both of those components make up the light and communications tower.
And this is a hub site?
This is one of three this is one of three Winstar hubs in Chicago. And Lurie has one of them.
Well, I want to stay with it. I don't want to change.
Okay.
I'm going to do the other one upstairs. Okay, so looks like we're just about ready to run out there, too, are we?
We have 3 minutes.
Okay, let's keep going. Ask me about the market. Again, about the
tenants. Do you have a lot of tenants that were asking for upgraded telecommunications?
There are tenants that have been asking for upgraded technology. Telecommunications is one of those features. Bandwidth, obviously, is one of those as well. And technology is just becoming more and more important to businesses in the city.
Do you find that you have been attracting tenants with this marketing strategy?
We've attracted 11 new businesses that are in the information technology business just this year alone. So having Winstar here enhances our amenities / necessities package that new businesses are looking for. I hope so.
As far as the Winstar people that you had to work with to get this project completed, tell me a little bit about how you feel about that.
It was a very interesting, complex experience, new to me, from negotiating a license agreement to dealing with the actual installation that you see behind me. It's a very complex situation that involves a lot of different parties, and it went a lot smoother than I could have ever imagined.
Do you feel
know, we've had that again because I didn't light it. Let's try that one more time.
Talk about the experience.
Once again, the experience with the Winstar people in Chicago has been exceptional. It took a lot of coordination from a leasing standpoint, from a managing standpoint, and from the technical installation standpoint, and I couldn't have imagined it being done any smoother.
Why could you have come up with another solution other than the Winstar solution that would have been fast and economical?
I don't understand the question, really.
Was there another telecom?
Fiber. What about putting, you know...
Okay. All right. Talk a little bit about your competitors. What we have at the LaSalle-Wacker building, in addition to the wireless communication that you see behind me, we do have fiber optics in the building that's provided by three competitors of Winstar. We do have cable television that's running throughout the building, provided by another competitor. But this completes the package. Winstar is a one-stop shop telecommunications company, as well as the fact that they provide a redundancy capability to the other TSPs in the building. And I think that is a true niche in the market that Winstar has.
I think that's good.
Great.
Okay.
So we'll let you go back in, but we do need to get you for the VNR so you get more of it.
All right. So second floor. Apartment.
So we're going to go to his office.
Thank you. sure.
Yeah, yeah. But they put them all three in one envelope.
At least they put them in the door. I didn't know if you were going to...
No, I did get them. It was among my checkout slip, and I was like,
so are you going back to
actually,
this
is deco, or not deco, right?
Designed by Hollibert and Root.
Well, he couldn't have blended better as far as the wind.
V-I-R-D-A.
It could have been.
I-R-D.
Just like Amberson.
Peaceful for Chicago.
R-O-O-T.
No. They're just
R-O-O-T. It was opened in 1930.
And that was their last picture.
Company. Bought the property in 1961.
Yeah.
And we've modernized them completely.
What is that, Rami? Next one?
Pipe.
And in addition to the LaSalle-Wacker building, we own 120 South LaSalle and 33 North LaSalle.
Did Winstar contact you, or did you contact them?
Initially, they contacted me.
Oh, yeah.
For the same reasons that Kate told me about. Geographic.
Now, what's the relationship between contracts and contracts?
No, this is primarily installed as an amenity necessity for tenants. It also benefits tenants in other buildings. Of course, he's concerned about what's happening here. It gives them, it gives the businesses in this building, who are tenants here, another choice for telecommunication service.
That was interesting.
The building has fiber optics. We have cable television.
All right, final score, Bears 35, Minnesota 17. Book it.
Okay. All right. So, how does the this tower affect the architectural integrity?
That was a major concern of ours. The antenna structure itself, the bottom 15 feet of the tower itself, houses the Winstar microwave dishes. We felt it necessary to add 24 feet of light pipe on top of that in order to aesthetically be more aesthetically pleasing to the building.
Okay, so I'm going to answer that question again. So what basically what you're saying is
what I'm saying is the bottom 15 feet doesn't look very good. That's why we enhanced it by adding this 24-foot light pipe on top.
Okay, so would you be willing to say then that with the total structure of the Winstar dishes and the additional superstructure on top, you feel that it's going to enhance the appearance of your building?
Correct.
Okay, so could you tell me that?
No, without a cue card?
Yeah.
Okay. There was a coordination effort between Winstar and the building's architects to...
We gotta wait for that thing. My wife doesn't even do this for me.
One of the major concerns the ownership of the building had was what would the structure look like. We worked together with Winstar's architects as well as the building's architects and achieved a aesthetically pleasing final product.
Great. How does this affect the intelligent infrastructure of the building? What does this allow you to do?
This enhances the telecommunications facilities that are within the building already. Fiber optics, cable TV, and now wireless technology.
The Lori Company owns other buildings here in the Chicago area. Does Lori Company, are they putting Winstar dishes on?
We are negotiating with them right now.
Okay, so you'd say we are negotiating with Winstar to put dishes on other buildings.
We are negotiating with Winstar to put dishes on our other properties.
Okay, say it again, we're here in Chicago. So we're negotiating with Winstar to put dishes on our other three properties here in Chicago.
We are negotiating with Winstar currently to put dishes on top of our other two buildings in downtown Chicago.
What kind of tenants need the services offered by Winstar?
Any type of tenant could benefit from using Winstar's telecommunications product. It's a wireless technology, and it performs. That's a good question. One which I'm not prepared to answer. Okay, I can't compare with the others.
Okay, well let me ask you this question. The kind of tenants that come in as a result of having this intelligent infrastructure, is that the kind of tenants you want to move toward in the future?
That is the type of tenant that we're...
I need you to say the kind of tenant we want to...
It's like Jeopardy. Yeah, use a question, please.
Yes, please.
The type of tenant that we're willing... The type of tenant that we are attracting to this building is one that's based within information technology. Winstar enhances our ability to market to those types of businesses.
Great. And, okay, I'm done with the stuff for this part, so send me here, Cynthia.
Well, we want to go.
Was this good guy, bad guy? Good guy, bad guy? You again? Okay. The livery company owns the LaSalle-Wacker building upon whose roof we're standing right now. It's a California corporation based in San Francisco, founded in 1922. We own and operate three large office buildings in Chicago, the LaSalle-Wacker building, 120 South LaSalle building, and the 33 North LaSalle building. We own 14 buildings in downtown San Francisco, including the Mark Hopkins Hotel and the Kieran Theater. I'm the property manager and vice president of the Lurie Company, responsible for all the leasing and marketing in the city of Chicago.
Tell us a little about the Chicago marketplace today, as opposed to maybe 3 or 4 years ago. What decisions 3 or 4 years ago led you to consider Winstar?
The marketplace in Chicago, currently as it relates to office leasing, is going ballistic. Vacancy rates are way down. The supply and demand is in the favor of the landlord, and one that we're trying to take advantage of. Prior to about 6 to 12 months ago, the market was very soft, a lot more supply than we were used to for a long time. So from 1990 through 95, real estate market was fairly depressed. We had the vision in late 95, early 96 to be proactive and look out and look forward and see what kind of amenities or in the case of technology, necessities, were going to help us market our properties better. And that's what led us and Winstar into negotiating for a hub site and their antenna structure today.
So you feel, in other words, that green is upgrade into a building, Winstar is going to help position you in the
The addition of Winstar's antenna on top of the LaSalle-Wacker building has enhanced our ability to market our space and ourselves to businesses throughout the Chicago area.
Do you actually have examples of tenants that, can you give me some examples of tenants that you brought into the building as a result of having this wireless fiber in the building?
We've made 11 new leases with businesses in the high-tech field just this past year. And Winstar was one of the many telecommunications amenities that we had in the building that attracted some of these folks. For example, intervisual communications from Santa Monica, California, Mac Temps is another firm, Environmental System Research Institute from Silicon Valley, just to name a few. Having Winstar as an amenity in the building helped entice these folks to visit us, and the rest is history.
Do you have any particular story that you can tell the tenant
that's
interesting?
Have
you had a particular problem that you offer solutions, now you have this amenity in your building?
Well, not really. We're in the business to give our tenants choices. And the more choices we can offer them, the more likely they are to either lease here or renew their leases here. So Winstar is one of many TSPs, ISPs, cable TV people that we've been able to negotiate successful leases with.
Okay, so
I don't think it's a case of outsmarting our competition, but I think the fact that we have provided tenants with choices and that we are visionary in knowing what's important to our tenants and what's important to the effectiveness and the efficiency of their business is to provide them with choices in telecommunications and technology. And Winstar has certainly helped in that regard. The idea for the Winstar structure here was a combined effort between the architects for Winstar as well as for the building. This is an Art Deco building, opened in 1930, so it's 67 years old. And the light and communications tower that you see on top of our building symbolizes where our business is going forward, and that is with an emphasis on technology. This will change the skyscape of the city, we feel, and provide a marketing beacon for our building. I can't remember what I said. This is all off the
really
top.
Good,
it's gone.
Tell us the story about how the antenna came up with the creative idea to get the antenna on through. Obviously, dishes that can be unsightly, and you have a very special building here in Chicago.
Yeah. We worked together with Winstar and the building's architects. Winstar was sensitive to our concern as to the aesthetics of the exterior of the building, and we worked out a program and a final plan that solved our concerns. They are the worst people you... once again, the Winstar folks that we've dealt with in Chicago... All right. Okay, all right. The Winstar project was an education for me, starting with the license agreement negotiation, as well as the planning and the installation of the final product. They were very sensitive to our concerns relative to all aspects of our negotiations. It was a team and joint effort, and so much so that we're actually sharing the expense of some of the items and the components of the structure itself. You want me to say something that's not true? No, see, actually, accurately, we dealt with your broker, your consultant, who happens to be a friend of mine. That's why Winstar is here. I mean, the bottom line, off the record, a friend of mine is your broker. That's why that's why this is here.
So, this whole negotiation process take?
Too long. Same answer. No, it was a very. This is going to be noisy. And what was the question, please?
What's going to the tenant mix in your building? What did you have before? What were you looking to accomplish by bringing this
back up?
This building is 96% leased. It has a variety of tenants, a very diverse demographic of business in the building. We're 96% leased. We didn't do this out of desperation. We did it out of what we feel is proactive marketing and partnering with our tenants' businesses by providing them choices for necessities in their business, i.e. telecommunications. We have a number of law firms, pension funds, architectural firms, website designers, software developers, and that's where the key is coming into play. By that I mean the typical office utilization of the past, the lawyers, the accountants of the world, are being replaced by information technology type businesses. And we're looking forward to those types of companies backfilling the space that the traditional office users of the past are letting go.
Thank you.
yeah, I have. It's an extract. Oh, no. Is it really fun to go out and look at the shoes? Is it?
Yeah. It was just like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.